Hello and welcome to Car Mechanic Simulator 2018 with me, Kevin Sawyer. Hope you guys and girls are all well and enjoying your day, whatever you're up to. Right, so today we are going to be restoring this bad boy here, which is the Land Rover. And let me bring up the notes quickly. Here they are. The 1997 Land Rover Defender, which I knew it was, but I thought I'd bring the notes up anyway. And obviously it's made by the modder of the name of Deadbob777. Yes, we've covered one of his mods, which was the Cadillac. And he's been putting quite a few mods out for this game. But let's crack on. Let's get this thing. See if I think originally this was a barn find or I bought it at an auction. I can't remember which. I think it was definitely one or two. It was definitely not a scrapyard job. Let's first of all see if we can jump in it and see if it starts. I doubt it, but it's always worth a try. First of all, let's remove the door then, because we can't open the door and get in it. Just looking around inside the cab, quite a lot of detail. Didn't start, I didn't think it would. Let's just tear the bonnet off. Might as well. But as I say, hope you guys and girls are well and enjoying your day. Let's do some testing. Of course, again, I will leave the link in the description down below for you peeps to have a go on this. And of course, it won't let me do a compression because I suspect it's probably missing something like a sump or something silly. I can't immediately not see anything obvious. Bits of engine that could be missing. Apart from the manifold, which wouldn't affect engine compression. But that aside, let's just see what the overall state of this is. So, yeah, 20,605. Yeah, I think I paid about 15 for this. Let's do the other checks. Does it have the one? It does. Onboard diagnosis tested on it. Or ECU. It's got an ECU engine control unit. That's all pretty millered. Let's do fuel flow. If you guys don't watch my Euro truck or American truck, or Farmer Simulator or anything else, like I said in those episodes, because I've been demonetized, I've now got to that point where I don't need to worry about copyright infringement on music, because I'm not getting any money from this. So, unless of course I continue doing it, unless I get into massive amounts of trouble, then you know, if they start blocking videos in certain countries or stuff like that, then I might have to rethink my strategy. But until that sort of point comes across, I'll continue doing it, playing what I want to play rather than playing what is copyright free. Right. Let's start taking body panels off, which needs to take the battery out, really. Stick it on charge. Got another yet model mod here, but next one would be this bad boy over here. Lag there, sorry peeps. Ooh, that was a bit of a weird, strange texture glitch in there. I don't know what was going on there. I'll leave the engine as it is because that's going to come out in one lump sum. So to speak. by the gearbox, obviously. Okay, my bad. Will this, is this a part? Yes, it is. Right, okay. Okay. Okay, let's go for interior disassemble. Will it let me do that? Yeah, it should do. It looks like just the front seat. Looks like those back seats are just... Yeah, they're just... Yeah, it looks like they're just part of the interior build. Okay, cool. So, all we need to worry about is getting the other bits out of it now. If I had to have a 4x4, I think one of these old Defenders would be probably one of the ones I would get. I won't get anything new. It makes me laugh because I was talking to someone, they've got a fairly top of the range Range Rover, and they said the first thing that the salesman said to him is, oh yeah, you can't take it off road, not in its present state, because it's only got road going tyres on it. You need to change the tyres out to mud tyres. I'm like, really? Okay, that seems legit, yes, that is true. But you're telling me even if you went off road with the road tyres on it, it's just going to cripple it at its knees. It's just going to sit there going, nope, that's not road. I'm just going to sit here and spin tyres all day long. So you might as well just buy some mud tyres or off-road tyres and drive them on road. It'd be noisier, admittedly, but... If you do plan on using it off-road. It wouldn't be as economical either, I don't think, if you're using it on off-road tyres on road. There's extra drag. But mainly road noise, I'd suspect. I suspect a lot of the farmers have a laugh. So if they went into the Land Rover dealership or whatever, and they said, "Oh yeah, what spec do you want that?" Well, yeah, I just want a basic spec, mate, with off-road tyres on it, please. And they probably laugh at all these people on these 4x4s that just never take them off-road. That's what off-roaders are meant to make. They're made for taking off-road. I'm sorry, but that's what they're made for. That's why the farmers used to use them all the time. Not because they're a status symbol, because they used to get them around the farm. Only because they could become a sort of like what I call a weapon of mass destruction now, because one lot of people have got them and some people feel intimidated by them, they have to buy one themselves, so then they, and it's almost like an arms race. Instead of nuclear weapons, it's 4x4s. But when they did that crash test, everyone, I remember that Top Gear that time, and they did the crash test of those, that 4x4, I think it was a Range Rover Discovery, I think, and the Renault 5, I think it's Renault 5, I think, Renault Estate, anyway, and you could still open the door on that and get out. On the Land Rover, no, you couldn't. And in fact, because the way the violent forces pushed the front bulkhead in, it caused the pedals to spring up, which would have broken both the driver's legs, or at least fractured their shins, because the shock of it going back up was there, putting both the foot and both the feet on the clutch and the brake pedal to stop on an emergency stop situation, as every normal driver would be doing. Both the feet would rather, well, both the legs, shins would be at least broken, or fractured to a point they can't walk anyway. So even if they could open the door, they wouldn't be able to get out. Well, they might be able to crawl out. Either way. I mean, ever since I've watched that, it's like, all those people thinking that they're safe in their car ain't so safe at all. Admittedly, if it rolls over, they might be safer. But I've never liked... I'm not a big fan of 4x4s anyway. I do like the old, like I say, like this old Defender. I'd like that. If someone said to me, oh, do you want one of these? I'd have said, yeah, go ahead. They'd come up to me with a brand new, like, Range Rover or something. I'd just be like, nah, thanks. Just give me the money. Wouldn't be seen dead in that thing. Just too much, too big. You know, I'd prefer smaller cars. Get around in. Not so like, you know, I like the old Mini Coopers, old VW Golfs, stuff that you can fling around quite quick, easily. You park quite easily. You don't have to worry about low bridges or small car parks or stuff like that. Whoops. That can actually come out. Can that come out? Yeah. Oh, this is an unusual exhaust system. I'd say that was borrowed off of the Shelby. That looks very Shelby. Well, AC they call it on this. Was it? Yeah, I think it was AC rather than. I don't remember. Right, that's more or less all off. I think I've got to take this front suspension off. Like I was saying with the music, I'll continue doing this music until either I get 1,000 subscribers again, then I'll go back to royalty free. Or if, you know, if the people really enjoy it, then I might keep it as a whole. Does this come off? It does. Cool. I might get these lights come out as well. Nice. Forgot to take these out in all the excitement. That's out, isn't it? There's nothing else we need to take off this, is there? Well, that bumper might need to come off. And those lights need to come off. That number plate needs to come off. I think that is it. I need to whip the engine out now. I don't think it's got any oil in it, so I'm not going to bother trying to drain it. Pull out. Thank you. And then stick, t- take it out of my pocket and stick it on the crane. Or stand, I should say. There we go. Let's go and separate the wheels and suspension bits that we can. Separate parts. Thank you very much. Obviously, if people wanted me to keep continuing using my music, even after we got 1,000 subscribers, obviously then I'd need to stop, you know, saying, you know, donations are the only way to get around that. Otherwise I'd be earning no money from YouTube at all. Wish I'm not earning any money from YouTube at the moment, but you know what I mean, guys. Again, they'd say off-road tyres, again, would be no good in snowy conditions. They'd need snow tyres instead. Which makes sense. But there is a way around that, just getting the snow chains. You just have to be very careful with snow chains, because obviously they can flail quite quickly and cause a lot of damage quite quickly if you get it wrong. Well, this is quite slow. Lots of little bits to do. Something didn't make it. Cool. In that instance, I think there was lights there. I think. I didn't look. Either way, let's go and get the welder. Move the welder over to the lifter one. Or lifter A, whatever they want to decide to call it day. Is this one of the ones that have both into... Oh, that comes off as well by the looks of it. Aha, yes, okay. Right. Do these come off? Oh, they do. Okay, my bad. Technically, these bits do come off as well. You could, they was normally pop riveted on, but... Can't blame the modder overly too much for not having it in. Just make sure everything's off this thing now. Fuel tank, everything but the fuel tank. Right, let's go and whip that out quickly. Forgot that in all the excitement. Should be at the back here somewhere. Of course, it's still got the pumps in it, so take that out. Take that out. See if we can repair any of that. That won't be the fuel tank. Oh, I didn't make it. They all made it. That's quite good. Right. While that's doing that, let's just quickly grab those bits of broken suspension. Stick the next lot of separate parts in. Right, let's bring it back down to the ground. And I'll weld it. Right, mind your eyes, peeps. Welding in progress. There we go. Now, did this have both the interior and exterior? So, let's go and get the valeting kit. Move that to this one. Ramp one, whatever you want. Cool, no, use the welders. Move. Use. Return to sender. Look away, look away. Return to sender. Return to sender. Cool. Right, and I'll leave it at that, peeps. But I hope you guys enjoyed the first episode. Well, not the first episode, but the first part of this restoration. If you did, please feel free to like, and if you didn't enjoy this for any reason, please feel free to dislike, but please leave a comment down below so then I can improve in the future. If you know anyone else that may also enjoy watching this, again, guys and girls, please feel free to share. It helps me out, I don't mind you sharing. And if you're new to my channel and see future episodes of this or anything else I'm working on, please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. TTFN.